Good evening, staff. I just wanted to take an opportunity to explain to you guys, our ELA teachers, kindergarten through fifth grade, a new protocol that is going to enhance our planning sessions and make the work more equitable, feasible, and better for all. This, I don't want to just say a new method because for some of you, you're going to find, for many of you, that this is a great way of doing things and it's going to seem like a relief has been lifted because it's actually less work. However, if this new presentation makes you feel overwhelmed or like more work, it might be due to the role that you've currently played in the lesson planning. But as a team of learners, collaborators, and educators, we are all here to work together. So I'll try to keep this very brief, but basically, in schools of excellence, all teachers, all members of the learning community, take pride in their lessons, the delivery of those lessons, are aware of the standards and appropriate instructional delivery methods by which to teach. I do understand that sometimes, and I've heard, conversations about the cumbersome processes included in lesson planning. And after kind of gathering lots of collection of thoughts and ideas, I think that in some instances, many people are working harder than necessary. And what I want to do through this, the goal, beyond just making sure that we are all aware of the standards and that students are getting the very best instruction, but this is also is an attempt to reduce workload and leave our lesson planning sessions with materials in hand and a game plan. So basically, through this presentation, the things that I'm going to present, when you leave each session, this will satisfy the completion of the lesson plan for the upcoming week. So in essence, if you complete it as assigned, only thing you have to do is if you choose to tweak it or add to it, that's up to you. That's on your own, but not required. So this whole new way of doing things, or more improved or better way of doing things, more efficient, is called potluck lesson planning. So when you think of a potluck, each person brings something to the table, but then you kind of get more than what you actually brought. And in most potlucks that I've ever attended, people don't come to a potluck. For instance, if it were a cake, I'm not going to come with the cake box, eggs, oil, and all that, and make it there. I come with it already prepared so that we can eat and enjoy and then, leave. So that's what we're going to do, is we're going to come with a piece of the pie or the item that we're assigned to bring to the potluck already done. And then everyone leaves with an actual tangible object in their hand that they just have to go and refresh and relook at so that they're prepared to deliver the lesson plan for the upcoming week. So to take you to these documents and explain it a little bit better, I want you guys, when you're on your class link, you will go to admin docs. Okay, everyone, admin docs might look a little bit different depending on what you have access to, but once I am there, I'm going to click over here on admin docs, and there is a couple of folders I want to draw your attention to. First aid documents, and then later on there's this curriculum folder, Chasing the A, with lots of great things that will help you as you make better lesson plans. So in the first aid documents, there are two new items that are put in here that I want to bring your attention to. The first is going to be an Excel file that right here it is labeled ELA Potluck Planning Rotation Schedule for the remainder of the year. Now, it is done for the remainder of the year. It is not to be edited in any form or fashion, but it is for you to use as a reference or a guide. In this document, the whole school, K-5, is put on one document. Now, it might look a little, it actually looks different here, compared to how it actually looks on my the other computer due to the way it is. I'm going to go ahead and click edit in Excel. I'm not going to edit it. But I just did that so that it might look a little different for this presentation purpose. just so that you can read a little bit better the column headers and kind of see what your role is each week. I could have had this already pulled up, but the purpose of the demonstration was to show you how to go in and get it yourself so that if you were to lose the email or delete the email, it's in the cloud and it's always there for your reference. So thank you for bearing with me, and I don't know why it's taken so long. I'm here alone. Actually, Karen Davis is sitting across from me and has been a great, great help keeping my brain straight. So there we go. All right, guys, so when you look at this, you will see here is kindergarten, first grade, second, third, those are your headers, fourth, and fifth. And I purposefully this time decided to put everybody on one page because we need to understand that all the work that we do together as a staff, it really, guys, is a K-5 effort. It is not a 3-5, a 4-5, a 2-3. K-1, it is everybody working together. So there are going to be components to your lesson plans that you need to bring each week. Now, when I say that, and I say the planning session, lesson plans, what you bring will satisfy the requirements of a lesson plan. I am not so much concerned with how you put it in a template because there are so many nice templates out there, but when I go and we are walking the classrooms, no one is necessarily holding a template in their hand, or we're seeing lots of different things. And we know through some conversations that sometimes one person is doing second grade, somebody's doing third grade, somebody's doing social studies, somebody's assigned to do this. And so that way has to change in a school of excellence. And that is what we will be here at Alta Vista. So I've decided, in conjunction with ELA coach and staff, to take the main points or the main components of what should be in a lesson. Now, we've already talked about STEAMR. That hasn't changed. That's just the overall acronym for when you are delivering your lesson, making sure that you have the standards. Do you have the learning targets? How do you engage your students? What do you ask them? The assessment prompts. I've given you guys all those tools or these acronyms, but now it is time to actually have something tangible that we leave with so our lesson planning sessions are fulfilling, meaning, and we leave with work already done. So what you will do is let's start with kindergarten. I'll just kind of do a quick run through it. You will see that kindergarten for the week of 12/11, so on next week by Monday at 3:15 p.m., in the lesson plan folder, each person is required to have their component uploaded so that it is already ready so that I, Mr. Gaimon, and Ms. Clark have an opportunity to preview and ensure that that your piece is there. This is a guideline, guys, that I will stick to very I'm just gonna stick to it. You're required to do one thing for each grade level, and I need you to have it in there on time to give your colleagues the benefit of having that, and so that we are prepared for our sessions. In the event of absenteeism or anything else, each person still needs to contribute their part. So for 12/11, we're actually vetting the lesson that we will deliver the week of 12/18. So we're working ahead, but not too far ahead. We will only work 1 week ahead at a time. Therefore, if we need to tweak it, make changes, we'll be able to do that. And your role will stay the same. For each, if you teach multiple grade levels, then you'll have a role for second and a role for third, or vice versa. If you teach just one grade level, you might have double assignments on a particular week. In K-1, where we are really trying to build a very strong foundation, there might be more presence in the actual planning with the reading coach, where she's able to pull back and scale back in some of the other grade levels and serve as that support. So, for instance, when we look at kindergarten, and this goes across all grade levels, our topics are standards. You see that the standard and the supporting standards deconstructed and explained in a student-friendly term. So basically, and we see, I'll use Miss Weedle. Miss Weedle for the next 2 weeks is assigned this part of the plan. So Miss Weedle, in a Word document, you are going to type out the standard and any supporting standards. And don't forget about our LSI tool, guys, where all that's already broken down for you. But you're going to come with a Word document. I say Word, if you choose to do Excel, it really doesn't matter to me, but it needs to be something that is tangible that you can print out and give to all of us, and something that you can upload. So your choice and way of doing that is up to you. If you choose to put it in a PowerPoint and go through it that way and then present in a PowerPoint, that is up to you. You just need to have your portion done the best way you see fit to have it done, upload it, and bring some hard evidence so that we each leave with an item in hand. So describing this one, standards and supporting standards, is you need to know, we always start with the standards. What is the standard that we're going over? Now, that doesn't mean that the other seven people don't have to look at that. Of course, you have to look at that to be able to do your part. But Ms. Weedle's responsibility this week is to plan for that standard. And basically, what you're going to do, Ms. Weedle, is just explain it, and then explain it to us in kid-friendly terms, maybe showing what you would circle, what words would we bold, how would we write that so that students would understand that. And then also with that, what, you know, would the success criteria be? So keep in mind that we want to always refer back to the success criteria. So right here, standards and supporting standards deconstructed, you will tell us about the standard, any supporting standard in kid-friendly terms, success criteria associated with that, and remember to keep those learning targets. Don't forget that piece, guys. Those learning targets must be included. Okay, your LSI tool that was purchased for you will take care of that for you. You just bring it to the table so that your colleagues has a copy of that. And if you so choose to, as you're looking at the course of the week, break that up. If there's multiple standards, that might be something that can be discussed actually in the session, but you bring it there and we'll know on which days we're teaching that. But it's pretty much said and done based upon the stories, because they're already outlined for you. So then we see Miss Melendez, and in kindergarten and first grade, these are double assigned because they're writing a little bit less. You guys will do the pre-filled out graphic organizer from the curriculum map that would go with passage one or story one, and also story two. Now this changes when we get to second and third grade, fourth and fifth, but for K-1, the person assigned will do the graphic organizer for stories one and stories two. Now, by pre-filled out, that means that when you bring this item, and we're talking about the graphic organizer from the curriculum map, because that is what drives instruction. Now, I know when you guys create those, some add an additional column. If there's three stories, they tweak it, but it needs to be the derivative from the curriculum map. You want to have that pre-filled out with an appropriate student response. So when you fill out that graphic organizer, no longer are we going to just come to planning sessions and say, here is the graphic organizer. No, we're going to bring a graphic organizer already completely filled out so that we can hand one to each of our colleagues. Therefore, that document will serve as a guide so that when we are leading instruction, we know what we're looking for. But just looking at, you know, guys, a blank document, and I think sometimes we're still left wondering what really goes in here. And let's take that out. Let's get rid of that. Eliminate that barrier. Come with it filled out with an acceptable student answer. And of course, that's based on the stories that I know that you guys are reading ahead of time. All right. Now, next we look at the story specific STEM questions and acceptable student responses. So someone will have to do that for the first passage. Someone will have to do that for the second passage. Okay. Again, you are looking at the story. What questions do you want to ask? We're always talking about higher order thinking questions, assessment prompts, but do we really write good questions? The truth is some do, some don't, but that's going to change due to potluck planning. So you will come with appropriate questions, making sure, guys, that we are referring to test item specifications, test design, FSA documents, item specifications. I may have said that. Any other tools. The great thing is now you also have your ready materials, which has some great examples of really good questions. So because in most grades, I know 2 through 5, we're delivering ready the week before, that might also be a great source. But I don't mean just come like, how did blank affect blank? No, if we're reading Pinocchio, how did Geppetto's response to, whatever affect his decision to whatever he does with Pinocchio? So you want to make sure that you, in your questions, you put characters' names and you put, real items that are in that story so that, because this isn't just for you, it's also for your colleagues as well. And they're going to ask those students those questions. And then they already have the answer. So that's one thing that they don't have to do. Okay, so two people are assigned that portion. Then we have to look at our technology integration. So this is something that, how are you going to integrate technology with that lesson? Now you can say, I'm going to pull up the Reading Wonder story and I'm going to show that. But that in and of itself is not sufficient. You want to, there might be like a media clip. Look at those standards. Sometimes those standards get very robust and there are multimedia presentations. It might be a small YouTube clip, very short, but it needs to be a way to integrate technology. It might be we will integrate technology by reading the following passage online. For instance, if you have computers, you can talk about I station usage as well, but that's more of what you're doing during your small group. But what is a way that you can integrate? Now for K1, I want you to just focus on found your foundational skills. So whoever, like Miss Vega, then the next 2 weeks Miss Perez, Miss Clark, Miss Melendez, Guido Santiago, going down, just I want your technology piece to be your foundational skills integration. So whether you do that through a PowerPoint or a smart board presentation, whatever is beneficial and conducive to the grade level, focus only on foundational skills. Grades 2 through 5, you have some variation with that. But again, when we're looking at the EPCs and we're looking at, I believe it's 1D technology integration resources, in what ways are your students interacting with technology throughout the lesson? So how do we set that up for them? Are we doing a Kahoot? Are we doing the quizzes? Are we doing are we doing clickers? What are we doing? If you have iPads in the classroom, not many people here, that will probably be more Holbrook, and you have to do that. Make sure that if you present something, it is something that everyone can use, okay? And then we look at the next one is standard align writing integration task with appropriate student response. So in a lot of our, like when we look in our fourth, fifth grade, they are having a lot of trouble with a lot of our fourth graders. Like, do those kids ever write? Did they learn how to write? And the truth is some did and some did not. And in schools of excellence, we all have to have high expectations, and all students, beginning in kindergarten, even some of our pre-K students, can and should be expected to write. Writing is not something that is done in an isolated silo, but it is something that is to be done in our lessons. We, have that question 11. There are summarizers. Writing is part of your graphic organizer, but there are appropriate writing tasks that should be done throughout the week. And the prompt may be something that asks the students to summarize, and it could be something that they've read that week, but it needs to be tied to the standard. If you guys need some really good help with that, I was in a classroom today and Miss Teresa Williams, who teaches students in fourth and fifth grade, has a great thing that she does with writing. And the great thing with that writing piece is it also then extends itself as a independent activity during small group instruction. So though you are creating it and introducing it during the whole group, this is a task that they often finish during small group. But I did see there's great things going on in her room with writing. All our fourth, fifth grade, I'll be honest, you can talk to any one of them from Chumney all the way down. So there's Miss Chumney, Miss Jimenez, Miss Owens, Miss Powers, Miss Tuff, and I start with Miss Williams. If you guys are struggling a little bit with that, they have some great ideas. Don't be afraid to talk to your colleagues across grade levels. Again, in schools of excellence, this is how we do things. We don't just depend on our own knowledge, but we seek out the expertise and we actually value the expertise that others bring to the table. And then each week, Miss Clark will wrap up your lesson planning session with the follow-up and some small group reteaching strategies. So you guys, when you look across kindergarten, you have the same thing in first grade. Come down, second grade, you have the same thing. Third grade. So when we get into second, third, fourth, fifth, you will see because we teach two grade levels, guys. For instance, in second grade, Ms. Doyle, this week you are doing your standards for the week and your targets and the success criteria. However, when you look at your third grade, Ms. Doyle, you are doing the writing piece. So if we do two grade levels, we aren't doing the same thing each one. So basically through the course of the rest of the year, each person will be assigned to one task per grade level for 2 weeks, and then we will follow a rotation schedule so that at the end of the year, everyone would have been exposed to each part of the lesson plan multiple times throughout the end of the year. Again, if this makes you feel nervous, I don't think that it should, because everybody is bringing a piece to the table and no one should be home on the weekend spending 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours working on these type of things. You guys have the 2 days here on campus where you have your collaborative planning sessions. Sometimes we have an occasional PLC, but those other 3 days, and I know sometimes there's IEPs and different things, but I really try to work with the ESC department to schedule those not during your planning, but during a time when there is coverage already in your room, so that you have that self-directed planning time to do what it is intended to do, and that is to plan. However, please keep in mind that I am available. Mr. Gaymon is available. Now, you might have to prearrange something with us because, you know, it could be hit or miss. Don't ever forget about the wonderful resource that you have in your ELA coach. She is here to assist and to help. There's 3 other days that if you want to meet, you want to plan, we're available. Also, don't forget about Karen Davis, who is walking around here. Yes, she might be coming to pick up Johnny, but she is a wealth of knowledge. And in Schools of Excellence, we tap into all resources. You have Mr. Woodard, who's serving as a reading interventionist and who knows the standards. There are multiple people on this campus, so we have got to come out of those silos, seek the help that we need if we need it, and just bring our piece to the table. So again, just in summation, each person will bring a tangible hard copy of their portion of the lesson plan to the actual PLC. This will satisfy the requirements of the lesson plan. So again, there is no need to go and now some people already have, like, I've already done lesson plans for the year, but you know, sometimes that's the lesson plans from last year, and we know with our 39% that we need to do some tweaking. So regardless of what's already been done, this is the new way of how we're going to have our lesson planning session, so no one will come unprepared. So now I want to go over just quick protocol of how you would do that. If you go back into the admin docs, and guys, I showed you how to get to that file. There is the potluck planning agenda that's already in there. You click on that and open it so you can just see the protocol and be familiar with it. So in a 45-minute ELA lesson vetting session for whatever week, there'll be, and this is, you know, give or take, but we need to stick to the time. I put times on here on purpose so that you don't go past your time. You have 5 minutes and you are responsible to present your portion. So whoever's in charge of presenting the standard, you have 5 minutes. The person who has to bring the pre-filled graphic organizer. And again, guys, with that standard, that's learning target and success criteria. STEM questions with answers for passage one. And then we'll look at the graphic organizer. And that could be reversed, the graphic organizer if necessary. But again, the questions and the graphic organizer, all of that's driving your instruction and should be in conjunction with the standard. So we'll have 5 minutes on each of those for passage one, then 5 minutes for the graphic organizer and the STEM questions for passage two. So again, graphic organizer, STEM questions. No, that's correct. I just was looking at the wrong line right there. Then number six, standards, aligned technology integration piece. Remember, K-1, you only do your foundational skills. 5 minute presentation, standard aligned integration task with appropriate student responses And then small group reteaching strategies. Wrap up will be Ms. Clark. Now, again, just so that we all understand, we are working the week ahead. So this week, when you have your self-directed planning days, you know, part of that time, if you so choose, because it's your time to self-direct as you want, but you could be looking at the week ahead so that you can get that work done at school. You only have your portion of it. And again, we are here to help. It's been talking all day. Karen needs some water. Excuse me. So that gives us 45 minutes of planning and then just some preparation and planning session protocol. These are things that I think I pretty much highlighted in the video. I talked about how you want to make sure that you upload your document by 3:15 on Monday for the week that we are vetting. And remember, we're vetting the week ahead. Look at your chart. You have to bring a hard copy to pass out. Please have a copy for each team member, the academic coach, and the administrator. Each task must be completed. Don't bring empty templates. Don't bring me a prompt. Bring me a prompt with an acceptable student answer. This helps your team members because, if the truth be told, many people leave wondering, okay, what is it that I'm supposed to do and how do I do this? But if you have, it's like having the answer key. Now I can look at it and look at what I'm expecting, which then changes and it shapes my frame of reference for when I'm interacting with my own students. So each team member must present his or her own portion. If absent, again, it's your responsibility. Have it in there. Someone else can pick it up, but you have it in there. Everything has to be standards aligned. We've been talking that talk. Now we're going to ensure we're walking that walk. Here are some documents in appropriate places where you can find that, and I'll show you that right before the close of this video. And always be courteous and polite to your colleagues. And as I said, these documents will satisfy the lesson plan completion for the week. If you require a lesson plan book where you want to write them down, if you need a binder, if you need a template, then that is on you. If you require a smart board file, that is on you. I require nothing in above what I've asked up here. Now, however, keep in mind that your small group management is still up to you. So again, in small group, I am okay with just documenting what skills you're working on with which students, because there is no need to create some elaborate piece. Just know that I'm working with group one on this, group two on this, and however you've been doing that, as long as you've been doing that, is fine. If you've not been doing that, please ensure that you start. So whatever template that you have, where, and Ms. Clark has given several, make sure that you have that and that it's visible. If you have any questions, again, don't hesitate to ask and use the chart if you so choose to collaborate with others. Instead of sincerely, I will sign Chasing the A, Principal Leatherwood. So one final thing in closing, I want to take you back to Admin Docs. And if we go to Admin Docs, that folder was the 2017 first day documents, although we're well beyond the first day, but we are still doing what we need to do to get it done, because you have to fix it until it's correct. We're going to go down to, there is a folder here that's curriculum folder, Chasing the A. In this folder, there are a wealth of documents. Now, I'm specifically in this video speaking to ELA teachers. However, math people, there's a folder. Science people, there's a folder. I don't know if there's a class management folder that Mr. Fashenko has added in there. So let's look in this ELA folder. If you open it up, look at this plethora of resources that many may not have ever looked at, but you know that they're there now. Here are these right here where it says Power Hour. There is no need to refer to those anymore. Those were the documents that we worked on that were done in Power Hour the first 4 weeks before we've implemented Ready. Thank you guys for your hard work on that. But there are many things like assessment approval, checklist, ELA, that is a test design summary right here. I think that says updated. There are STEM questions. So for instance, I'll open this up for first grade. So if you're first grade and you are assigned to write questions, here might be, you can look here at the standard and some specific STEM questions. But again, don't just give me blanks. Put in the actual names of the characters. Also, you have your item specs that you can look at as well. This resource is from Kids at the Core. And it goes all the way down through all of your standards, and it gives you the basic remember portion, and it takes it up. Because remember, don't forget your DOK levels. You guys know that everything isn't recall. Some things are at that next level. So again, and remember that FSA in 3 through 5 has the right to assess above the actual DOK level. Remember, the DOK level is actually the floor, not the ceiling. Okay, so these resources are in here for all grades. I know, like in 5th grade, this week we're looking at point of view, but down in 1st grade, when we're looking at point of view, we need to make sure that those students are asked the appropriate questions. So if you have questions based on the stories, here is a resource. Integration of knowledge ideas. We talked about that. Remember, 3rd grade, we didn't do so well on that last year. So 4th grade, keep an eye on that. We're going to do a better job in 3rd grade this year. But guess what, K2? This is a 1st grade standard. So in 1st grade, in kindergarten, we have to make sure that we are asking and teaching those questions, because, again, in schools of excellence, we all work together. And I'm not saying by any means that anyone hasn't been, but our data speaks for itself. And so we want to just make sure that we're all working collaboratively together and that we're all bringing something to the table. So that document, as you can see, there's other documents in there. That's like a computer-based testing folder. That was a question bank for grade 1. Here is a question bank for with stems for grade 2. There is a question bank in there right for grade 3, and it just goes on and on and on. Guys, months ago, these resources have been in there. And a lot of times I have these ideas. Well, I won't say ideas. I have not this knowledge, and I try to deliver it to you all in a manner that isn't overwhelming. But in schools of excellence, guys, there has to be a sense of urgency by all people in all areas. And I want to commend some staff members today who just, there was a staff member who had to unexpectedly leave. And, you know, somebody just picked it right up. And these, I'm talking about some of our certified staff, and said, I'm going to go in and teach this grade level so that those students don't miss. Someone else out of the blue came up and said, I'm going to go in and ensure that those students star test and make sure that those conditions are right. And I've seen things like that. Then someone else said, I'm going to go back and teach this other grade level. So we are working together as a team, forging a vision that will lead us to be a high-performing school with the ability to not only get there, but the ability to sustain. I was talking to some of our 5th grade teachers who have that afternoon planning, and I've heard how one of them, you know, like they've had their plans caught up. They went into a power hour session at the end of the day, and one of the other groups, due to a para being out, and actually served in that group. That person put aside, you know, their right to just, you know, work alone, and saw the need to help a group of kids who need to desperately learn how to read. So I just want to encourage everyone to keep on trying. Help us as we chase the A. I hope this new style of lesson planning expectations, I hope that it gives you a sigh and a, ooh, this is, you know, a lot easier. Or maybe it gives you a sense of purpose. Each person will interpret it in their own way, and that's okay. But if you really look at it, each person is only required to do a small portion, but you are required to be competent and cognizant of what's going on in that lesson. No longer can we just come, and we're not going to come and complain. We're not going to come and just get, but we're going to give a little, and we're going to get a lot more. We're on a tight schedule, and we've got about 5 months to victory. We will see it. We'll see it together. And if you have any additional follow-up questions, please do not hesitate to ask. And Ms. Clark is available. I'm available. And we are here to help. Have a blessed evening. And make sure you tell your colleagues they need to watch this video, because if they don't watch this video, there is not going to be a PLC on this. I need to say that, and I don't mean to be rude, but I do need to address the fact that a lot of you all don't read my emails. And you know, can't make you read anything, but I will tell you that if you aren't reading my correspondence, then who's guiding? As the principal of the school, it is my duty to ensure that you guys are aware, and it could be lengthy, but it is my job to communicate. And it is not for a lack of. Now, I do slip up sometimes. I get tired sometimes, but most times I send very thorough documentation. But in some instances, people just don't read them. They don't read them in time. And that is doing a disservice to you, your students, and your colleagues. So please share with your colleagues this important informational video so that they are aware. I'm not going to print off anything and put it in your box. We have to do our part. We have to be aware. I do encourage you, don't let them slip, because then that's going to be, already being behind. But you might just kind of put it out there. Hey, have you seen the video? It's very important. And I appreciate everything that everyone's doing. We're here to assist, and I'm going to sign off and go home, Miss Davis and I. You guys be blessed. Have a great evening.